Hey guys, I'm Rachel and welcome to our 100th episode of NBA 2K TV.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show, sponsored by Kia.
Hello, everybody. Glad you could join us here on 2K Sports. I'm your host, Ernie Johnson. Next to me, Kenny the Jet Smith and Dr. Shaquille O'Neal. And on tap tonight, it's the Sacramento Kings going up against the Toronto Raptors. For Toronto, they've got an opportunity tonight to sweep the season series 2-0. The coaching staff commented that they feel confident coming into this one. And a chance to check out Kyle Lowry here, one of the more underrated guards in the league. But he is as tough a matchup as you will find.
I call him the little pit bull. You know, I actually seen him, the late, great Eggman, who was assistant general manager at Memphis at the time, introduced me to him. Fantastic leader, tons of passion, great will to win. Doesn't get enough credit, man, and he shoots the three ball just with anybody in the league.
Took him a long time to become an all-star, but now you can pretty much pencil him in.
That's right, Ernie. And when he gets a hot hand, he can absolutely take over a game with his shooting. And his passer reminds me of my main man, Pistol Pete Maravich, straight out of LSU.
Wow. That'll do it for now. Almost time for tip. Here's Kevin Harlan.
This is 2K Sports broadcasting from Sacramento as the Kings take it to the hardwood. Alongside Chris Webber and Greg Anthony, I'm Kevin Harlan, the fourth member of our crew. From the sideline, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
The Raptors swing into this game as part of their continuing road trip. And, of course, Buddy Hield. A lot of what he's been doing in his first several games with his new team, just feeling things out, using that basketball instinct and learning the playbook.
And as you were mentioning, I mean, that trade has this team buzzing. You can see it in the warm-up line, how loose and confident they look now with him on that roster.
And as things get ready to roll, let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's on the sideline. David?
Well, guys, DeMar DeRozan is a great dribble penetrator, but three-pointers are not his focus. He said, I feel like I can get to the basket at will. So it feels like settling. Instead, I could have gotten fouled, got free throws, or an easier shot. I'm not discrediting the three-pointer at all. I know I can shoot it. I just don't. Kevin?
And three-pointers certainly on the rise. We'll see if he sticks to his guns. DA, thank you. And these teams both, in some ways, throwbacks offensively, Chris. They look to score in that low block.
Well, it's harder to score these days. Much easier to help defense than back in the day. Nowadays, when you post, half the time is to create a shot for a teammate.
Good point.
And it's the Kings to start out. So let's take a look at the Toronto Raptors starting lineup. The explosive pair of Lowry and DeRozan are the backcourt. Ibaka is out there with P.J. Tucker. And it's Valanciunas in at the five, roaming the paint. And it's Kufis missing. Outside DeRozan. Back to Lowry. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
And it's always nice to get the easy look inside for your first points of the game.
Collison kicks to Kufis. Rudy Gay on the wing, guarded by Tucker. The drive by Gay, and he lays it straight in.
Oh, you got to respect Gay's ability to bury shots on the drive. He gets to the rim in no time.
Lowry kicks to DeRozan. And just about a minute into the first quarter. Tucker with the ball. 9 points last game. Just 4 to shoot. And it's DeRozan missing.
The defense got super lucky there because he does not miss many of those.
Deflects the pass. Cauley-Stein passes to Collison. Cauley-Stein in the post. Ibaka on him. The shot by Cauley-Stein. No good. On defense, the Kings. Last time they met was in Toronto where they beat the Raptors.
Yeah, and they picked up the win in their last game against this club, and really it was a parade to the free throw line.
Incredibly aggressive. Drew a lot of fouls on the other team's starters. Made them go deep into their game.
And Ibaka slams it in.
Yeah, just the length and explosiveness. Ibaka is a true force at the rim.
Heel dishes to Collison. There's a screen. Pass to Kufis. And the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a three-point play.
Wow, what a smart play. He recognized the height advantage and went straight to the rack.
And Coach Kufis is such a valuable player to have off the bench for a team, Chris. Gives you spacing and size, and he really knows how to play within himself.
Well, Kev, Kufis is usually productive in whatever role he is playing for a team. His versatility to start or to be the first big off the bench is really what makes him valuable.
Now, here's Valanciunas, one of the dependable scorers on the team. He's averaging close to 17 points a game. Outside Lowry. The three. A nice shot by Tucker. Tucker's got his first 3 points of the game.
There's a chance he could go for a big game if they don't D him up on the perimeter.
Outside Collison. He dishes it to Cauley-Stein. It's stolen by DeRozan. Fast break Toronto. Here's Lowry. Score the basket, his second of two attempts.
Well, that's why they're in front. Aggressive play at both ends. Nicely done.
Here's the screen. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
Now, one of the issues the Kings have had over the last decade or so is that they haven't had much consistency at the coaching spot. That turnover is a recipe for chaos for a team.
And with the Kings, you understand the desire to go out and get the best coach for a team or to change things up.
Well, that's a big thing that nobody seems to understand with the Kings. In order to improve, you need to have some consistency year to year and make a commitment. You just can't blame it on the players if they don't have consistent leadership. Hopefully they can have a coach last longer than three seasons in the next decade for the sake of the players and the fans.
And good on the second, so he makes them both.
Obviously one of the better free throw shooters in the league. We expect this out of him.
Valanciunas with a screen on Collison. Here's Tucker. Off target from outside. The Kings have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today. Gay kicks to Cauley-Stein. Right through the D for the layup.
And it's important for Cauley-Stein's confidence that he gets these interior shots to fall. The more he sees the ball go in, the more assured he will feel down inside.
Now here's DeRozan. He's coming off a 19-point game against Denver.
Really surprised he clanked that one. He makes those on the regular.
Collison with it. Lowry picks him up. Collison kicks to Gay. And the jam by Rudy Gay.
Oh, big finish. Emphatic.
He hangs on the rim just for good measure. Toronto trailing. Here's DeRozan, looking for his first basket still in this one. Off the screen, shot's good by Ibaka.
And offensively, Ibaka's been spending more time out on the perimeter, but watching him work inside there, you realize that may still be his bread and butter.
Now, here's Collison. 11 points for him in that last game against the Clippers, and it's good for two.
And really, it's been a major aspect of their offense in the early stages here. Their success working the ball inside and getting points from close range.
Here's DeRozan. Some stats for him. He averages over 21 points a game. And Tucker kicks to DeRozan. That doesn't go either for DeRozan. For Sacramento, they've gone 5 of 7 today so far. Nice shooting to get this game underway. Healed the pass to Kufis. Sacramento moving it around. Gay against DeRozan. The pump fake kept the D off balance and gave him room. 6 points for Rudy Gay.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting it in the paint and continue to score consistently.
Lowry with the ball. Picked up by Collison. Up top DeRozan. Puts one up from 19. That doesn't go either for DeRozan.
A frustrating start to this quarter for him.
Here's Collison. And again, it's Sacramento converted.
The mid-range area of the floor is so important, and Collison knows how to shoot from there.
Come on.
And here's Lowry. 14 points from him the last game against the Nuggets in Denver.
And he also was a table setter in that game, Kevin. Just an amazing job with his passing. Just a joy to watch that.
On the clock, Tucker. And again, Toronto no up. Kings leading now by 6. Guys, we've seen some excellent offensive output.
Yeah, great momentum for them offensively.
Gay drives in. And the pass to Kufis. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line.
And just a nice bucket there to really just sustain that lead.
Oh, well, that's a solid play and basket right there. And the lead continues to grow.
Ty Lawson, he's checked in for Darren Collison. Chris, you had a lengthy career that spanned a decade and a half. In all your years as a player, who was the biggest trash talker that you either played with or against?
Well I'll tell you what, Larry Bird was a big trash talker. I got a chance to play with him in Dream Team and other basketball-type settings. He was one of them. You also got to go with my man GP, Gary Payton. He was a big trash talker, and I'd probably have to go with my man Larry Bird or GP. Gary Payton, 6'4 GP. I was on a plane with him one time, and he was talking trash in his sleep. So, Gary's somewhere talking right now, playing the game. So, yeah, that's Gary's style. Gary's he's the biggest trash talker I ever met.
And last year, Kyle Lowry took another huge leap in his development. And yeah, the points, the steals, and the rebounds were fantastic, but I thought the bigger part was the fact that the discipline he showed in the offseason to drop the 25 pounds. You know, you factor that in with his shot selection, and that discipline is one reason why he was an all-star and rapidly becoming one of the very elite guards we have in our league.
Here's what Sacramento's going with right now. Anthony Tolliver. He's checked in for Willie Cauley-Stein. Flalo comes in for Rudy Gay. And it's Ben McLemore in for Heal. Here is Tolliver. 8 points his last outing. Yep, it counts. And the Kings lead by 8. And talking about the progression of Lowry's game, some feel his improved attitude has had a lot to do with that.
You hit it. He was hard-headed when he came into the league. Didn't always get along with his coaches. Now, though, his maturity, his real confidence, those are areas of growth that have allowed him to just settle in and play his game.
Toronto shooting their first free throws of the evening.
Yeah, pretty good numbers on the season when you look at their free throw attempts.
Two
right
shots.
Around 78%.
The free throw drops for Powell. And Chris, you're part of perhaps one of the most exclusive clubs in NBA history as you were selected first overall in your draft class. What was that like? What an experience that must have been.
Oh, man, it was a wonderful moment. I mean, you know, I worked so hard to get there. I come off of disappointment in college. And so working hard and being able to kind of put that behind you and get right to the next level and be the number one pick, you know, I was just honored. I was thankful. I was humbled. It was just a blessing, you know. And the craziest part about it is that it happened in Detroit at the Palace, where I won 2 state championships there. I won 3 state championships in Michigan and 2 specifically in the Palace at Auburn Hills. And so that place is always going to be special to me. And just growing up and being the number one pick, it was just an honor. Anthony Tolliver isn't a player most teams worry about in their scouting report, but he can hurt you if you give him space. He's a very strong shooter at the power forward position, and he commands attention.
First one falls for him. And with Tolliver, Chris, he is great in the pick-and-pop situations.
And Kevin, he's strong, rolling to the rim as well. Not many power forwards can be an offensive threat in as many ways as Tolliver can in the pick-and-roll. Not one of the more well-known players in the league, but there's a reason why he's always getting minutes.
Hits one, then misses the second attempt from the free throw line.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
Out of bounds, Sacramento will take possession. Let's check out some of the best shooting teams out there. The Kings in second.
So patient on the offensive end. I mean, they're not going to force shots, and it's that selectiveness that's yielded such an impressive field goal percentage.
Last outing for Toronto, unsuccessful. It was a loss to the Nuggets.
And just looking at the stat sheet, they gave far too many free throws away in that game. Maybe it was the noise in the building or something, but they really looked rattled.
Well, if you want to quiet down a hostile crowd, missing your chances from the line just isn't one of the suggestions I'd put in the suggestion boxes how to do it.
Sacramento shooting their seventh and eighth attempts at the foul line tonight.
And they've been ordinary on the season as well, just about 75% from the line.
No good on the free throw. Chris, you know this league as well as anyone. You were a leader when you played, and I'm sure you would gravitate toward that kind of player when you watch the game now. Who would some of those players be?
You know, I really like Chris Paul. I think he's always been a leader. LeBron in Cleveland, winning that championship, getting his teammates together, getting that team together. I think he's been a leader, too. And Damian Lillard in Portland. Look at what he's done, losing all-stars, fighting, not making the all-star team, fighting for his team, getting them in the playoff run. I love Damian Lillard's game a lot as well.
Well said. He hits the second from the line.
And they've clearly been the aggressors here early on, drawing fouls and working themselves to the line.
Now the feed to Poeltl. They set the pick. Joseph up top, Austin defending. Just five on the clock. The Raptors need to get a shot up. Patterson can't get it to go. Here's Sacramento. They're on an 18-5 run. A follow, no good.
I'm a fan of anybody who defends that way. I mean, they weren't about to open the door and just allow him to cruise in for a layup.
Now, here's Patterson. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change.
Great playmakers help everything run so smoothly. Excellent lead pass.
Here's Lawson. 7-point differential. Passes to Kufis. Back to Lawson. To the paint. In the corner, it's McLemore. Kept alive. Tolliver dishes to McLemore. A follow outside. And he overshot that one, missing.
Beautiful execution in terms of creating space for his shot. He just couldn't get that one to fall.
Patterson can't get it to go.
You know, they don't score on that shot, but they're going to be happy with those kinds of possessions.
Kufis. Rebound by the Raptors.
Oh, we've seen him posterize guys with that move many times. However, the defense proved to be very stifling. When he gets it that close to the basket, usually it's a sure flush. But the defense stepped up and stopped him cold in his tracks.
Here is Tolliver. And right now he's averaging about 7 points a game. A shot by Lawson, wide open. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark. Pass to Kuboka. Lots of room. Kufis grabs the miss. Kings leading now by 7. For 3, Lawson. It's good from long range.
Defensively, they've got to pick up the intensity. Hard to win surrendering this high a field goal percentage.
Back to Powell. 1:44 left in the first quarter. Patterson, that's good.
And defensively, they're on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Sacramento's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Lawson kicks to Tolliver. Back to Lawson. Tolliver the pass to Lawson. The shot, no good. Now Toronto takes it the other way. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Now, here's Joseph. Tight defense on him. He feeds it to Poeltl. 11 feet out, and he hits it.
And the soft hands of Poeltl on display there. Just has such a nice stroke from the mid-range.
Lawson outside. Feeds it to Kufis. A follow right side. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. That's on Patrick Patterson. The Kings have shot 5 of 8 from the foul line. He's off on the first. The Kings making a switch here. Labissiere's checked in. Serge Ibaka, he's checked in for Toronto. And he sinks the second.
Yeah, a lot of whistles here early, as well as foul trouble starting to be an issue.
Now, here's Joseph. Boston defending. Hurdle's shot is off. Kings leading now by 7. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Tolliver for 3. It's good for his second make. He's made 2 of 3 so far.
You could not diagram a better way to open a quarter.
It's really the ideal start that any team wants. Now they have to ride this wave throughout the rest of the game.
Now Joseph. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. Ibaka outside, shoots from the elbow, no good off the front iron. Domination in the first quarter, it's been pretty lopsided. It's Sacramento, up by 10. Live from Golden 1 Center, you're watching 2K Sports. And Serge Ibaka, becoming known for his shooting ability now, he talked about the confidence his teammates and his coach instilled in him.
He trusts you. Every time he passes the ball, when you don't shoot, he screams you, shoot ball. Then next time what? You will shoot. And if you miss, you say, yeah, good shot. You know, and your coaches in the practice talking to your teammates. Man, when Serge is open, give him the ball, he will make that shot.
Well, if you wonder how much difference a coach can make for a player, there it is.
Huh? You heard it in Serge's voice, too. That confidence has already been planted in him. That voice telling him, shoot the ball, is now in his own head. He's going to be just fine.
And welcome back. It's been all one-sided so far through the first quarter as our second quarter gets underway. And for the Kings guys, what jumps out to you stats-wise?
You know what? They're dominating on the backboard. They have controlled the paint thus far.
Yeah, they came in on a mission, absolutely flying around the rim. Their relentlessness has been unmatched.
Gay and Cauley-Stein fill up the forward spots. Collison is out there with Heal, and it's Labissiere in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the 5 to begin the second quarter for the Kings. Ahead, here's DeRozan. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup. DeRozan's got his first 2 points of the night.
Just no resistance inside at all. They are feasting. This is a straight buffet.
It is. It's a big one. Load the plate. And it'll be Sacramento as it goes out of bounds. The Kings retain possession. Off the inbound. And Cauley-Stein throws it down. Second quarter of basketball, about 1 minute played so far. Valanciunas with a screen on Collison. It's blocked.
You have to be cautious when Labissiere is in the area. Those shot blocking skills are superb.
And finished off by Gay.
And check out the hops from Gay. Just throw it up to him, and he'll take care of the rest.
Raptors trail by 10. And the Raptors, they've come a long way over the past few years in terms of their competitiveness.
And what I like about the Raptors front office, they're unafraid to reshape the team when things aren't quite working. 2 years ago, they were much more about offense than defense. Last year, they were an upper echelon defensive team, even if the offense suffered a little bit.
So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Now, Willie Cauley-Stein was considered a bit of a reach for his draft position, but you have to love how he plays at his size. Very active inside with his feet to flash open on cuts. Just shows great awareness for a new player in the league.
He's off on the first. Well, you hate to use the P word, potential, but you can't help but do it with Willie Cauley-Stein.
You're right, Kev. I hate the word potential as well. It just means unrealized talent. As long as he moves as well as he does with his size, he'll be fine.
And he's good on the second.
Now, when you think of Cauley-Stein, the word limp comes to mind. A huge target on offense and a tenacious shot blocker and rebounder on the defensive end.
That one goes in.
And the pass was right in stride. Extremely accurate setting up the shot.
Kings leading now by 9. Outside Collison. Gay outside. Kicks to LeBissiere. Gay dishes to LeBissiere. 4 on the shot clock. And it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
And one thing with Rudy Gay is that you know what he's going to give you each game. One of the more reliable scorers in this league.
And Chris, for Rudy Gay, he's reliable. Game to game as a scorer.
And you sure can't overstate how important that is to a team. You always want to have someone that can get buckets every night. Rudy Gay has been that guy his whole life.
And free throw good from Gay.
Out of sync at the line, it's really been a consistent problem for this team.
Patterson, he's checked in for Serge Ibaka. Rudy Gay hits them both. One item with Rudy Gay, Chris, is that he is very aware how to take advantage of a mismatch.
And that awareness, Kev, is something that has made Gay such a reliable scorer. A lot of players have one way that they prefer to get buckets, but Gay is comfortable doing whatever it takes. He's gotten better over his career and taking what the defense gives him.
Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Well, the league and NBA teams have become much more aware of protecting players' health, and they're finding out that rest and sleep are a huge part of that. Warriors head coach Steve Kerr said medicine and science have improved and thought processes do as well. He said in the old days, guys played 48 minutes. Well, we've made advances. We don't go backwards with this stuff. We go forwards. And guys, that's why they want their players off their feet as much as possible.
Good report, DA. Thank you. Well, one of the biggest names in free agency GA this past offseason was DeMar DeRozan. Many in Toronto feared he would leave the team, but he re-upped with the Raptors on a huge deal.
Yeah, and DeRozan spoke about loyalty to the franchise when he announced he wanted to return to Toronto. It's the only team he's ever played for his entire career, and easy to be loyal when you're getting almost $30 million a year. So it's a great contract for DeRozan.
Now, the Kings haven't had too many deep runs in the playoffs, but they have had some fantastic players over the years. Ever since their move to Sacramento in 1985, they've had some of the most exciting talent in the league.
Now, here's Collison. He provides a good amount of offense for the team, averaging around 11.5 points a game. And DeRozan, here we go. And he drops in the layup off the glass. DeRozan's got 7 points in the game.
And of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
Game with it, guarded by Tucker. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him. And Chris, I would agree that most fans would call you the greatest Sacramento King ever to play.
Well, you know, we've had some great players, and Oscar Robertson wasn't in that Sacramento era. I'm lucky for that because he's one of the greatest players of all time. And you can also make a case for Mitch Richmond. His teams didn't win, but he was an incredible scorer.
And he can't get the first one.
Oh, well, Kevin, throughout his career, Gay has been an offensive force and mastermind at manipulating defenses.
He hits the second from the line.
Well, of course, two Canadian teams were born to the NBA in 95. But back in 2001, the Vancouver Grizzlies became the Memphis Grizzlies, leaving the Toronto Raptors as the sole Canadian survivor.
Now, here's Tucker. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game. Over to the left wing. Lowry inside the line. The Raptors rebound. Headshot off.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside.
Here's LeBissiere, and lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two. What's interesting about the Raptors and Grizzlies when they first entered the league, the Grizzlies were actually the team that seemed to be on the track for big things, but lately the tables have really turned.
Yeah, and what's surprising to me is that as we've tried to appeal to more people in more countries with our game, we still have only one franchise located outside of the U.S., and that's the Raptors. The NBA is seeing a rejuvenation in revenues, but if we want that growth to maximize, we may need to try and broaden our international horizons.
No luck that time either.
At 6'11" and about 225 pounds, LeBissiere is a long guy, someone who uses that size to his advantage.
Raptors trail by 7. Inside, and it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Lowry. And some great passing here so far. Let's check out this chart that breaks down where the assists have been coming from for Toronto.
This backcourt is really shouldering the load in terms of the ball movement and great assists. When you look at the overall contributions compared to the bigs, nice work on distributing the ball.
Kings leading now by 7. Now here's Collison. And Valanciunas pulls it down.
And that's the way you want to defend. Nice job there.
That's what I'm talking about. That's just picture-perfect defense there. Really stifled this man and gave him no chance at a clean look.
A shot by Lowry. No good. The Kings have gone 2-6 in the field in the second quarter so far. Here's Game, and he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And there's the foul. It's called on Toronto.
And the astonishing athleticism of Gay puts defenders in a bind. He knows how to get under their skin.
3 trips to the line so far for him in this one.
And take a look at what he's been able to do at the free throw line. 82% more than acceptable.
Good from Rudy Gay.
Strong take to get the foul there after not getting it there in the first quarter.
And so he hits both.
And another disappointing season for the Kings last year. They fell out of the playoff race early on. They just couldn't keep pace with the rest of the conference.
Now, here's Patterson. Taking a look at his stats, he's averaging around 9.5 points a game. Count that one, and the Sacramento lead has been cut down now to just 7 on the bucket from DeMar DeRozan. Outside Collison. He kicks it to Gay. Back to Collison. And there's the call on Kyle Lowry. So that will be his second foul of the game. We're in the bonus, and we'll go to the line to shoot 2. And while the Kings were improved last year, it didn't seem like they made much headway towards their ultimate goal.
Well, right now, they seem to be lacking a direction for the team. There's an air of uncertainty about who they want to build around. They will need to answer some hard questions in short time.
And he makes the first.
Now, what you have to like about Derek Collison is the fact that he gives you a little bit of everything from the point guard position. He can shoot it from deep. He can attack the basket depending on what the defender gives him. He acts as a true facilitator for the rest of the team when he's manning the point guard.
And Chris, with Collison, as you said, he is a jack of all trades as a floor general.
Well, a lot of it is that Collison knows what he can and can't do and plays within himself. Always plays to the tempo of the game.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
The dish to LeBissiere. Down low. And Cauley Stein throws it down.
Wow. At 7 feet tall, Cauley Stein is a major threat to throw it down. If he gets the ball close to the rim, the D is pretty much toast.
Outside DeRozan. Shoots off the screen. A tad short, but it's good off the front iron. Tucker's got 5 points so far.
Perfect screen there. Set him up with a terrific look.
Nice off-the-ball movement and action to free him up for a shot. He makes on a regular basis. Outstanding work.
Now, here's Collison. He's got 6, and then Gay with the dunk.
And when Gay gets the hot hand, just keep feeding him. He can really stroke it from any area of the court.
So, timeout called here. The first for Toronto.
And they're picking up a lot of fouls already in the penalty. Not a good sign. They need to focus on moving their feet and maintaining a good defensive position.
And the Kings will go for a different look here. Kufis checked in for Willie Cauley-Stein. Flalo comes in for Rudy Gay. McLemore's checked in for Heald. And it's Lawson in for Darren Collison. And then for Toronto, Pirtle comes in for Valanciunas. And Norman Powell subbed in for P.J. Tucker. Raptors trail by 9. Powell kicks to Lowry. Back to Powell. Knocked loose. They get the rebound. Pirtle, no stopping him there. Jams it in as he's fouled. Chance now for a three-point play. It's going to go on Scalabissier. And the Raptors with some changes. Caboclo, he's checked in for DeRozan. And it's Joseph in for Kyle Lowry. Raptors have split their free throws right down the middle so far. They're 2 for 2.
And Pirtle is a massive guy, someone that uses his height exceptionally well to get high-quality looks at the bucket.
Now, here is Lawson. Dishes to LeBissiere. Back to Lawson. Pass to LeBissiere. And Pirtle pulls it down. Raptors trail by 6. That's tipped. Lawson with it. Goes back up. And it's good on the layup. Kufis has got his 3rd basket of the night.
Where's the box out? Some easy second chance opportunities there.
That's just the real lack of physicality in the post there. No reason at all that they should have gotten the rebound off that miss.
And Joseph kicks to Pirtle. And the shot counts. He's fouled. Good. And it's a chance good for a 3-point play.
And they haven't worked it inside as much as they did earlier in the game. Now that they have the lead, they don't seem as determined to pound it down low. And the 7-footer, Jakob Pirtle, a smooth, fluid athlete for his size. And he's got tremendous bloodlines, guys. Both of his parents were members of the Austrian national volleyball team.
And Pirtle picking basketball over volleyball. I guess you could say it worked out for him.
Yeah, I mean, they said growing up in Vienna, there wasn't a good youth volleyball program nearby, so he just went with hoops. And standing 7-1, I'd have to say it's worked out pretty good for the big fella.
And it's going to be a goaltending call here, so they'll count the bucket.
Yeah, you got to like the aggressive D going for the block, but he got it just as it was on its way down.
Here's Powell. He's averaging just around 8.5 points a game. Pirtle sets the pick for Joseph. Terrific design on the pick play, and he lays it in.
Come on, he's so zeroed in. Going to the rack. He didn't face much resistance, though.
Kings leading now by 4. Lawson drives in. In the corner, it's McLemore. That shot is off. And Toronto will go the other way with it. Now the Raptors moving it up. Here's Powell. Off target from the baseline. The Kings have gone 6 of 13 so far from the field here in the second quarter. And a follow kicks to Kufis. And good. Got the English that time as it falls. Kufis has got 9.
I mean, on offense, he has been a constant force. You get him the ball, and there's a good chance he's going to knock that shot down.
Back to Joseph. Puts it up from 12. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot.
Good.
One free throw coming his way.
Good.
Outstanding job there of taking the harm and still able to finish.
Anthony Tolliver. He's checked in for Sacramento. And the Raptors also making a change. Serge Ibaka has checked in for Patterson. Free throw good, Joseph.
And they're getting to the line a lot in this quarter, guys, and it hasn't been by accident.
Now here's Lawson. He dishes it to McLemore. The pass to Tolliver. Here's Kufis. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up. While we've got a moment, let's now take a look at the teams that have the most second-chance points on the season. Fifth best, the Kings.
And just having a terrific year on the offensive glass, it's because everybody buys in. Not just the big men, but even the guards are getting in on the act.
He misses the free throw.
Now, this is Dave Yeager. Before working in the NBA, he was one of the most successful coaches in minor league history. He won 5 titles in 7 seasons, all before turning 35.
And the second free throw, good. And Coach Yeager grew up coaching. His father was a high school basketball coach.
Well, yeah, Dave would help him scout opponents, watching game tape, help get pops ready. Even his senior year playing point guard at Moorhead State, he volunteered to coach a semi-pro team. Coaching has been in his blood for a long time.
Now here is Poeltl. 7 points in the game. And here's a follow. Here's Tolliver and the powerful one-handed slam.
I mean, maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that one.
And we know he's capable of those memorable ones. Here's Powell. It's Poeltl, top of the key. Screened by Ibaka. Caboclo, the pass to Joseph. 6 to shoot. Baseline try. It's rebounded by McLemore. Kings leading now by 6. To the inside. And it is flushed down with a nice jam.
And the recognition of McLemore, a team-oriented player who is always looking to dish the rock.
Foul for 3. Raptors get it back. Here's Ibaka. And at last, they get one to fall. Ibaka's got his 3rd bucket of the night. Lawson outside. To the middle. Here's Aflalo. Another miss for him. Now shooting 1 for 4 from the floor. Raptors trail by 6. Screened by Ibaka. Here's Powell. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. It's on Ben McLemore. The Raptors have missed a few free throws up to this point, shooting 4 of 7 from the foul line tonight. No good on the free throw. Good on the second free throw. We've got 1:18 left to play in the first half. Now Lawson. The feed to Kufis. Back to Lawson. to the inside, and he jams it after taking the nice feed on the run.
And how about breaking out the Statue of Liberty on that dunk?
A nice way to pad that lead a little more, you're right. And Joseph kicks to Ibaka. Back to Joseph. Here's Pirtle. And he overshot that one, missing.
His shot is not on target right now. He better figure this out fast.
Tolliver kicks to Aflalo. Passes it to Kufis. And again, it's Sacramento converting.
The chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
Raptors trail by 9. Joseph dishes to Powell. Pirtle kicks to Joseph. Kufis with the block.
And hard work on the glass once again, guys. And they put a lot of effort and focus on the backboard.
Oh, you have to admire the intensity of McLemore sprinting towards the hoop and jamming it home with some real force.
Now, here's Joseph. He has 5. Good. 9 points for Jakob Pirtle.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
And we've reached halftime in this one. Kings lead by 9. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. Here with Coach Dave Yeager. Coach, what is going to be the focus offensively going into the second half?
Well, we try to go inside. You know, that's our strength anyways. For us, you know, our bread is buttered inside, so we try to play high-low. And then if the threes come out of that, great, but we want to try to get everything to the rim.
Coach, it all starts with that entry pass to the big, and then everybody plays off of him. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, and we'll be right back after halftime to start the third quarter. See you in just a bit.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, folks. Welcome back. Ernie Johnson here with Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. This is the Halftime Show on 2K Sports. Rudy Gay has been getting it done. He ended up with 15 points, 3 assists, and 2 rebounds. Shaq, how did you think the Kings were playing?
Well, they've been playing with some toughness. And it's led to a nice lead for them, not just on the scoreboard, but in the rebounding numbers. And now they need to stay mean, Ernie. You cannot lose that edge in the second half.
Kenny, let's get your thoughts on the Raptors.
Well, it's good to be physical, but there's a line that you don't want to cross. You can't constantly give up free throw chances by fouling guys too aggressively. You have to get back in this game by staying poised, smart, and avoid fouling.
That, sadly, wraps up the halftime show.
No.
The third quarter set to begin in just a few. We'll see you right here, though, after the game, so you have that to look forward to.
Kenny had so much more to say.
A nighttime glimpse of the Tower Bridge, one of the landmarks here in Sacramento. Welcome back, everyone, to the capital of California. All right, the second half beginning in just a moment. Rudy Gay having a dominant impact in this game.
You know, and as effective as he was at slashing to the hoop in that first half, even better at finishing once he got there.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's just his ability to play above the rim led to some highlight reel dunks and really pumped up his teammates.
Raptors trail by 9. And on the floor for Dwayne Casey starting the second half. Lowry and DeRozan, the core of this team at the guard spots. Jonas Valanciunas is out there with Ibaka. And it's Tucker in at the small forward. Heald with it. Outside Collison. And no good. And it's the Raptors taking it the other way. Oh, the lob to DeRozan. And DeRozan throws it down.
And hard to decide which was better, the pass, the catch, or the slam.
There's no wrong answer. Sensational alley-oop. Now here's Heald. Collison, the pass to Gay. Pass to Cauley-Stone. It's stolen by Ibaka. Lowry inside the line. It's hauled in by the Kings. Cauley-Stone's got his 4th rebound in this one. Inside, it's tipped, stolen by Tucker.
And Rudy Gay picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. And with a little over a minute gone, the second half is underway.
That's just the heart of Kali Stein. The heart that he possesses on defense is just admirable. He takes pride in contesting every shot he can out there. And the pass was right in stride, extremely accurate setting up the shot.
Raptors trail by 7. Lowry dishes to Ibaka. He feeds it to Tucker. Outside DeRozan. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Unloads. Offensive rebound. And Valanciunas kicks it to Tucker. Lowry passes to DeRozan. Valanciunas dishes to Tucker. Feeds to DeRozan. Overheeled. And again, Toronto no luck. Kings leading now by 7.
And DeMar DeRozan, kind of a throwback, you know, for this day and age when we talk so much about the three-point shot, because he's not a guy that's going to bomb you to death from deep. He's a high flyer who's going to attack the rim and get to the free throw line. And to me, that's extremely important, because the more attempts at the line you get, the more opportunities you have to set your defense. And so he beats people with that polished mid-range game and shoots an incredible number at that line. And those are reasons why this guy continues to improve and become one of the best at that off-guard position.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Healed with the bucket. Third quarter here, and 3 minutes have come off the clock. Lowry kicks to DeRozan. And it's Gay with the rebound. Gay's got his third rebound tonight. Outside Collison. Back to Gay. Takes it from 10. The shot, no good. Now Toronto takes it the other way. And Tucker has it in the corner. That three off the mark. Kings leading now by 6. To the middle. Kufis with it. Valanciunas is there. Here's Hield. Another 3 for Sacramento.
He's not your typical gunslinger from downtown, but he found a soft spot in that defense.
Lowry kicks to DeRozan. Here's Valanciunas. And that misses badly. Air ball. Down low. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot 2. And a chance now to review the shot chart.
And this is a grown man shot chart right here. Not too much going on outside, but look at how things are for them in the paint. They are attacking the rim and not settling for the jump shot. And right now it's paying off in bunches. If I'm them, then I'd continue to do the same thing going forward until an adjustment is made.
A free throw drops for Kufis. Labissiere has checked in for Willie Cauley-Stein. And Toronto also making a switch. Patterson's checked in. And Kufis drops them both. And turnover in the league. We're seeing it right now. A new commissioner, a new director of the Players Association. Chris, new owners. Do you like the way things are going in that regard?
I do. Basketball is in great hands, and thanks to our past commissioner, and I think that, you know, we have great leadership, and we're continuing in the way that we were going, and that's basketball for everyone. Mm-hmm. And I love watching the game expand, evolve, and continue to grow.
Well said. And while we have a chance, here are the teams that have swatted away the most shots this season. Number 1, the Kings. 5th, the Raptors.
And these teams have both hung their hat on their defense, especially in the paint. We're looking at 2 of the premier shot-blocking teams in our league.
And Toronto has possession. They trail by 11. Valanciunas with a screen on Collison to stop the run. Kufis with the block.
And physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team. A plus 10 rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
And Patterson kicks to Lowry. It's stolen by Hill. Lob pass to Gay, and it's out of bounds. The Raptors will take it the other way.
And a moment to see numbers for Jonas Valanciunas. Third in blocks, 12th in rebounding, and not many players convert opportunities inside as well as he. Top 15 in field goal percentage.
Lowry kicks to Patterson. Tucker the pass to Lowry. DeRozan dishes to Tucker. Now here's Valanciunas, defended by Kufis. Lowry bounces high off the rim and drops. Lowry's got 12 in the game. Kings leading now by 9. Here's Collison. He's got 6. Kicks to Gay. Baseline jumper. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him. Here we are in November, and let's see how things are going out east in the early season. Take a look at the Bulls. They've got the number one record in the conference, and because of it, each night out, their competition is going to bring it right at them. And, of course, Toronto, 5.5 games behind.
And for the Raptors, they had the kind of hot and cold start that we've kind of come to expect. Nothing that would indicate they're in for any kind of a breakout season.
This makes you wonder. Will they continue to be inconsistent as the season progresses? At this point, they look like they're still finding out their identity as a team, which is why they have struggled.
And the Kings making a change here. Tolliver's checked in. Collison hits them both.
And the 6 foot, 175 pound Collison is a vital part of this team. A speedy point guard who can get hot in a hurry.
And here's Tucker. He's got 8. Patterson up top. Outside DeRozan. Pulls it up. Raptors get it back. Lowry from outside. That's good again. His 7th basket. 7 for 10 from the floor. Kings leading now by 8. Collison kicks to Gay. LeBissier with the screen for Gay. Shoots the 3. The offensive rebound.
You know, his positioning near the hoop, always to his advantage. Just a terrific job to tip that one back in.
Here's Valanciunas, and he makes good on the layup. Valanciunas has got his 2nd bucket of the game to go.
Well, that's the range you want to shoot it from if you can get there.
Sacramento's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Heald kicks to Collison. The dish to LeBissier. And LeBissier throws it down.
And the finishing ability of LeBissier, absolutely phenomenal at jamming it down.
Outside Lowry. Patterson dishes to Valanciunas. Outside Lowry. 5 to shoot. And Valanciunas kicks to Lowry. Sacramento grabs the miss. Tolliver's got his 7th rebound here tonight. Dishes to Collison. He kicks to Tolliver. Kings moving the ball around. And LeBissier throws it down.
Oh, that's great TNT, baby. Explosive.
That was pretty, and he just has that effortless knack for getting inside.
And you can tell they're just a little out of sync. I think he just wants to get everybody back on the same page.
Yeah, trying to find their rhythm. It's a chess match, a constant back and forth of in-game adjustments.
Some changes for Sacramento. Aaron Aflalo, he's checked in for Gay. Ben McLemore comes in for Hield, and it's Lawson in for Darren Collison. Raptors trail by 12. Defense! Now Powell. Defense! It's stolen by McLemore. Defense! And now Aflalo pushing it up. No one back to stop him. And it goes down 2 points. Aflalo's got five now.
Well, I just love the hustle from McLemore, a real pest on defense who knows how to swipe the ball away from the opposition.
Caboclo kicks to Pirtle. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. Tolliver's got 8 rebounds in this game.
Well, they've been better than good on the glass today, and there is a glaring discrepancy between these two teams in that area. Now, flying high and throwing it down with the one-hander. Woo,
one of his favorite moves right there, guys. Powell, that's good.
And the double-clutch layup in that situation, that's just him playing to the crowd, guys.
Kings leading now by 14. Now, here is Lawson. Inside. Here's Aflalo. A strong finish under heavy pressure all over. He's got 7.
They have got to box out better than that. That putback's just another example of what a difference there's been between these two teams.
I mean, it just goes to show the lack of effort on their part. Their opponents simply want this game more than them right now.
To the inside. Here's Pirtle. It's deflected. A second chance effort. Here's Patterson. And at last, they get one to fall. Sacramento's gone 3 of 5 from beyond the arc so far tonight. Lawson outside. And Pirtle pulls it down. Pirtle's got his 5th rebound in this one. And Jakob Pirtle enters the NBA after 2 seasons at the University of Utah. Last season, he won the Pac-12 Player of the Year, as well as awards for the best center and low post player in college basketball.
Yeah, and he had an opportunity to play in Europe instead, but he thought the college route would be a nice experience. Certainly the exposure didn't hurt, and he made demonstrable improvement from year 1 to year 2.
Raptors have gone 5 of 9 at the line. Sacramento with the ball. At one point, they led by 16. They come into this having outplayed the Clippers last game.
And we've talked about how in the NBA, you've got to earn your points the hard way. And that really wasn't the case in that game for them.
I mean, you're right. A lot of wide open spaces. They were running around undefended all night. Oh, he hasn't started this game on the right foot, but it hasn't slowed his team from grabbing the lead.
Lawson kicks to McLemore. Labissiere. And once again, off the mark by Sacramento. Raptors trail by 11. Here's Pirtle. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here. It's going to go on Scal Labissiere. Raptors have shot 60% from the line, 6 of 10. The first free throw is good, and Toronto making a change here. Ibaka's checked in. So he hits both. Lawson with it.
I got yours.
Pass to Tolliver. Aflalo outside. And there's the pass to Tolliver. Lock at 6. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2. That one on Jakob Pirtle.
We're still waiting for that first miss from the line this half.
Take a break. 2 shots.
That free throw, no good. Willie Cauley-Stein, he's checked in for Sacramento. And he sinks the second.
And right now at about 85% from the line, that's up from where it was in that first half.
Powell kicks to Poeltl to the paint. And Ibaka slams it in.
And when Poeltl sees one of his guys wide open, he whips it his way. He's all for doing what's best for the team.
Now here's Lawson. He dishes it to Talon. 1:19 left here in the third quarter. And there it is for him. Raptors trail by 10. And Joseph kicks to Caboclo. The feed to Poeltl. Screened by Ibaka. Powell, the pass to Poeltl. Just four to shoot. It's Ibaka. That time on the assist from Poeltl. And that's 10 points for Serge Ibaka. Kings leading now by 8. Lawson dishes to Tolliver. Pass to McLemore. The tray. Rebound by the Raptors. Here's Toronto. They're on a 13-5 run.
Man, it's close, but, you know, didn't get on balance quick enough.
Raptors have made 8 of their 12 free throws in this game. Free throw drops for Powell.
This is as good as it gets from the charity stripe here in the second.
That's also good. So he hits both free throws. The Kings leading. Here's Lawson. 24 seconds left to play in the third. There's McLemore. Powell with the steal.
I'm open.
Poked away. And the Kings pushing it up now. Here's Lawson, and it's denied.
And you got to give appreciation to how Poeltl punishes shooters. A dynamite shot blocker with impeccable timing.
McLemore inside the line. No good. And we've watched 3 so far in this one. Kings ahead. They lead by 6. And we're coming back in just a moment. Get ready for the fourth quarter of action when we return. And from the most recent huddle, let's listen in on head coach Dwayne Casey.
But it's about defense down here. No second shot. Rebound we go. All right? But make sure. Make a miss. Get back. Here we go.
Wanting to make more plays, be fast end-to-end, Dwayne Casey injecting energy into his team.
Yeah, and when they're in attack mode, sometimes it can lead to turnovers. But it could also lead to a nice run here.
And we're set to start the action up here in the fourth quarter. And if it's anything like the first 3, we should be in for a treat. Kings leading now by 6. Gay and Cauley-Stein fill up the forward spots. Heald is out there with Collison. And it's Kufis in at center. So that's the 5 in the game for Sacramento.
Oh, I love to see the unselfishness from Collison. Really rips the ball over to the open man quickly.
Three-pointer, Lowry. Good on the three-point shot.
Wow, something's brewing, guys. The three-pointers just continue to flow.
Collison kicks to Gay. Throws up on the block. And it's good off the back rim and in.
The scoring skills of Gay aren't just limited to the mid-range and his perimeter. This is a guy who can get it done from the inside as well, thanks to his fantastic length.
Now, here's Tucker. Pass to DeRozan. the 15-footer, and the Raptors tack on two more.
Key buckets, and we know he delivers down the stretch.
Man, he shines when it matters most. They love getting him the rock in key situations like that.
Lowry against Collison. At the elbow, it's Kufis. They set the screen. Unloads from 13. And that's good for two. And the Kings lead by seven.
Yeah, that's asking a lot from that defender.
He was dead meat right from the start. He had no chance of stopping him from getting a clean look on that play.
How about the grit and determination in the post? I mean, essential qualities to have late in a close game.
Here's Collison after the made shot from Jonas Valanciunas. Collison kicks to Hield. He feeds it to Kufis. Goes straight through the defender for the dunk. Draws the foul. He'll go to the line. It's on Jonas Valanciunas.
And they got to bring the double team on him. Yeah, and their free throw shooting has really improved here in the second half.
Raptors trail by eight. Feeds it to Tucker.
Yo, set it up.
Kicks it to Valanciunas. There's the dish to DeRozan. Six on the shot clock. Back to Valanciunas. 14 feet away. Ibaka, no luck.
A good job by him on the glass here tonight. Plus eight in that department.
Collison, the pass to Hield. Now here's Cauley Stein. Not a lot of room. Gay in the corner. Ring shot on the way. Knocks it loose. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Gay. Raptors trail by eight. And here's Lowry. Dishes to DeRozan. Down low, Valanciunas. And the basket is good.
He's been blazing hot to begin this half after looking utterly lost during the first. Nice turnaround.
And the former fifth overall pick back in the 2011 draft, Valanciunas is still only scratching, people feel, the surface of his true potential.
And he's had a few bouts with the injury bug, Kevin, but when he's right, he's a load. Struggles defending on the perimeter, but his rebounding and rim protection have gotten more nasty as he's matured.
Raptors trail by six. Now Lowry, he kicks it to Tucker. Cauley Stein grabs the ball. Cauley Stein's got rebound number eight now on the night. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
Really the right play defensively. If you can't block, force him to the line.
Shooting two.
That's good from Rudy Gay. And good on the second, so he makes them both. And so here's Toronto. 8-point game. Lowry dishes to Ibaka. Screened by Valanciunas. Inside. The rebound by Hield.
And really credit their advantage on the backboard. That's where the lead has been built, and that's why they are in control.
Now here's Collison. And there's the call on Kyle Lowry. That will get him his fourth foul of the game.
And you can see he just didn't get squared up with his feet.
Here's Collison trying his luck deep.
His offense remains mostly absent, but he still has been a team player in helping get them the lead.
Raptors trail by 8. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
And there's the call on Kyle Lowry. That will be foul number 5 on him.
Yeah, really good defensive play to cut him off there and square up.
Outside Collison. Out left to the wing. Cauley-Stein kicks to Kufis. It's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot. Valanciunas. And so he's picked up his final foul. And he will sit for the rest of this game. Patrick Patterson. He's checked in for the Raptors.
Gentlemen, 2 shots. 2 shots.
Well, free throw drops for Kufis. Both shots good from the stripe. Raptors trail by 10. Toronto calls timeout.
Clearly, he's not pleased with all the looks they've given up on the inside and also to get them to tighten up that defense.
And they may have to address a number of things, including whether this is the right lineup.
And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Thanks, guys. I got a chance to hear Dwayne Casey talk to his team. He is not pleased, and he told them they have to make a push right now. He said, look, we got to make a move, or I've got to pull the plug. Pretty blunt stuff, Kevin. Back to you.
Thank you, David. Now, here's DeRozan, screened by Ibaka. And DeRozan kicks to Ibaka. And again, no good by Toronto. Sacramento leading by 10. Now here's Hield. He passes to Hield. Puts it up from 12. Nice spin off the left rim and in. Okay, he's got 6 in the quarter.
And then the razor-sharp focus of Gay. Never letting defenders get to him on these shots.
Here's Lowry. And the Raptors miss again.
He's got to be disappointed with himself on that one. He has got to knock those down.
Collison with it. Cauley-Stein with the screen for Collison. Here's Kufis. First free throw is good. Second free throw, no good. Raptors trail by 13. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Oh, no chance there for the smaller defender. Someone needed to rotate over and help.
For Sacramento, they've gone 5 for 9 from the field in the final quarter so far. Collison kicks to Kufis. Here's Cauley-Stein, and Cauley-Stein throws it down.
Oh, man, the relentless pursuit of the basketball by Kali Stein. Just a tremendous hustler on the offensive glass.
Here is Lowry. Shot on the wing. Gay with the defensive effort. Kings leading now by 13 to the inside. And Heal with the basket on the assist from Gay. Gay's got 4 assists in the game.
And just dropping the ball down inside, a timely assist.
Ibaka dishes to Tucker. Patterson, the screen. Tucker, the pass to Ibaka. And it's Ibaka again missing. Sacramento's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Heald kicks to Collison. Gay outside. Good for his 8th field goal. He's attempted a dozen shots.
Not a lot of resistance on the inside, and they're taking full advantage.
And that basket is going to count. Goaltending, the official call.
Almost got to that shot in time. Just a split second late there. Caught it just barely on its way down.
One shot. One shot.
And Ibaka, no good on that one.
And you love the defense that Ibaka brings to the court every game. Provides big problems for his matchup with his length. It's good to block at least a couple shots every night, it seems.
Nice shot by Cauley Stein, no good. Raptors trail by 15. Tucker with the ball. Gay picks him up defensively. And it's DeRozan missing. The Kings have gone 8-14 from the floor here in the fourth quarter. And with Ibaka and his defensive presence, it's not only the blocks he gets, but the threat of blocks that makes him great.
That's a great point. You see a lot of very talented players start to hear footsteps when they get close to Ibaka. It isn't just that shot blocking that you mentioned. It's his help defense and ability also to defend on the perimeter. Also incredibly strong and very difficult to back down.
The free throw drops for Kufis. Pirtle, he's checked in for Patrick Patterson. He makes 1 of 2 that time. Raptors trail by 16. Here's Tucker. Offensive rebound. DeRozan gets the bucket. DeRozan's got 4 points in the quarter.
Hey man, he's in attack mode, crashing the glass, then goes right back up with it.
Right side, Collison. Here's Cauley Stein. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here.
Now, you got to give major props to Cauley Stein for using his effective shot fake to draw the defense off the ground. Once they are in the air, he simply just goes up on them.
And that one falls for Cauley Stein.
And done a much better job from the line this half. They've gotten that percentage up over 80 for the game.
He hits both from the stripe. Raptors trail by 16. Lowry kicks to DeRozan. Here's Tucker. No good on the 3.
Is he trying to get a shoe contract deal? Because he's showing no interest in moving the ball right now. He's trying to make a one-man commercial. He's just content to try to get his points, and that's all.
Now here's Heald.
Oh, the officials are all over that one.
That free throw, no good. And the second free throw, good. Raptors trail by 17. Outside Lowry. Beyond the arc. That shot, no good. So the Kings will take it the other way. Collison kicks to Kufis. Gay dishes to Collison. Gay passes to Collison. Sacramento moving it around. Healed. And the three off target. Toronto's gotten some tough luck from three-point range. In the fourth quarter, they've hit just one of six from deep. Poeltl kicks it to Tucker. Pass to Lowry. Ibaka outside. And again, no good by Toronto. Sacramento leading by 17. In the corner, Collison with it. Shoots a three. Tips it. And here's Lowry. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Here's DeRozan. Kufis grabs the miss. Kufis has got rebound number 12 here already in the game. Let's it fly from 18. And he nails the jumper. And that's now 10 points for Collison.
Oh, the pure jump shot of Collison. You'd like to see
timeout,
him pull
timeout.
It from
there.
Toronto calls timeout.
Guard it.
Yeah, it looks like he saw some things out there that need to be adjusted, and it's going to take a break here and talk it over.
Well, I also think, Greg, he wanted to give his guys a quick breather. They're expending a lot of energy. They're expending a lot of energy out there right now.
The Raptors making a switch here. Caboclo's checked in. Lowry from outside. It's hauled in by the Kings.
And boy, has he been struggling big time here in the quarter.
Well, it hasn't been his best, just to say the least. He just needs to calm down out there and let the game come.
And the basket by DeRozan.
Oh, that's just great offensive skill, consistently helping his teammates generate points.
Kings leading now by 17. Collison kicks to Kufis. That shot missing. Now Toronto takes it the other way. To the right side. Shoots the three. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. Kufis has got rebound number 13 for him here tonight. To the middle. It's tipped. Now here's Hield. DeRozan defending. Kufis the pass to Collison.
And this is what they wanted. I mean, to announce their presence in this matchup with authority. Very decisive. It can definitely be considered a statement win for the Kings.
Their inside game was what secured them the win tonight.
They had their way in the paint. And those are all high percentage shots, but the defense couldn't stop them from getting down low.
And with this effort tonight, grabbing their eighth win of the year.
Really, they had their number this season. Two wins, a home win, and an away win. And a great team effort. But still, what an individual performance for Rudy Gay.
Well, look, the conversation about this win starts and ends with his performance. You can't find an area of this game where he wasn't front and center in what they were doing. He was their leader tonight. No questions about it.
And one thing about Kyle Lowry, he's an absolute pit bull out there, and he's been that way since he was a five-star recruit out of high school in Philadelphia.
Yeah, less about the sizzle, more about the steak. Physical, relentless, wears you down on both ends of the court, and for the last two seasons, a starter in the All-Star game. His toughness and leadership, championship qualities.
And it's a completely new group on the floor for the Kings. There's a minute left to play here in the fourth. Al Richardson, the pass to LeBissiere. Now, here is Lawson. Sacramento again missing.
And he has slipped into a funk. You can see the confidence is shaken.
Yeah, everybody goes through slumps. He can't let it get to him, though. Everyone makes mistakes on the floor. You just have to always be thinking about the next play.
Now, here's Richardson. Launches it. It's hauled in by the Raptors. Passes it to Caboclo. A three ball. Hits it from three-point range. Now, here's Lawson. D right on him. A follow outside. Tries to snap the cold streak. Jump shot is good.
And just a terrific job of taking care of business in front of the home fans.
Well, look, you always want to give your all for your home crowd. So far, they have done just that.
And so it's Sacramento easily grabbing this one. A confident win and one where they clearly showed the greater effort.
Yeah, I mean, it was a solid performance, particularly here at home. And I think they built off that edge of being here and play with just a little more confidence than their opponent.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. Rudy, congrats on the win. What was working for you on offense tonight?
I think our defense kind of got our offense into it. You know, we're that kind of team. Our defense makes our offense. We run the floor and we share the ball. So whenever we out there playing defense like we did today, we usually are in a good position.
Great performance tonight, Rudy. Congrats on the win. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much. And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Chris Weber, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA. Presented by 2K Sports. Now we'll send it up to the award-winning Ernie Johnson, who is standing by for the post-game show.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Hey, everybody. Ernie Johnson, along with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. It is time now to present our Jordan player of the game, Rudy Gay. Shaq, what'd you think?
Not many guys put as much pressure on opposing defense as Rudy Gay. He's a hard charger, drives the lane, attacks the rim, and can knock it down from the outside. All adds up with a player that is very hard to deal with.
He was a marksman from the field tonight. No wasted opportunities. He would just wait right there and strike when he was open. And there were few misses on his part.
That's going to do it for our broadcast tonight. We certainly hope you've enjoyed the show, don't we, guys?
It was great.
Yeah. Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, and for Kevin Harlan, and the entire 2K Sports crew, all 653,000 of them.
Yeah, it's a lot.
Hardworking.
A lot of people.
Yeah. It's a long line at the buffet, though. Yeah.
Shout out to the T-Poles, man.
Oh, yes.
I don't know
sure.
His name, but I know his face.
I'm Ernie Johnson. See you next time.